Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston Station, we are ready for the event.
JAXA PAO, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Mission Control Houston, please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is JAXA PAO. How do you hear me?
Hey, it's Kuba. This is station. You are loud and clear.
Thank you very much, Noguchi-san. Now we would like to start the communication. My name is Go. I'm going to be the interviewer today. So what is the situation over there?
Go-san, はじめまして。国際宇宙ステーションから野口がお話しています。
Mr. Go, very nice to meet you. I am Noguchi from International Space Station.At the moment, we are flying over 400 kilometers, and we are going around the Earth 16 times and doing various experiments. Today, I am looking forward to talking with you about the state of the Earth space business. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Now, before going into my question, I would like to start with explaining about the background.At the moment, the expansion into the business, space business by private sector is not the far future. In Japan, too, there are many companies that are starting a space business. And also, I feel that the space is becoming a concrete frontier for humanity, both as a solution to global issues symbolized by SDGs and also as an area for the creation of new industries.
So,
in preparing for the coming democratization of space, what do we need to know and what should we think about? So at this time, I would like to ask Mr. Noguchi, who has stayed in space three times, how close we are to an economic sphere that encompasses space. Now, I would like to start my question. My first question.In an interview with NewsPicks in 2020, you said that the reason humanity leaves the Earth is to evolve.
So
13 years ago, you had your first space flight, and compared from the time, do you feel that mankind had evolved? What do you think of evolution? What kind of evolution humanity had? Mr. Go, thank you very much for your question. Thankfully, this is my third flight. And so 2005, 2010, and 2020. So at the very milestone, I have seen various changes. Maybe in terms of evolution, we have to see in more longer term. However, in the past 15 years, I can see that, for example, utilization of privatization of the space and also new challenges with the creativeness of the private sector is being done in great scale. Well, thank you very much for that answer. Now, this is your third mission. So in the process of the initial announcement of your third space mission to the present, did you feel anything different from the past, anything that you felt very fresh and new?
はい、ありがとうございます。最初にゴーさんがおっしゃられた通りね、その宇宙の、
Well, thank you for that question. Just as you rightly pointed out, democratization of space or utilization by private sector, I think this time the access to the space itself was done by private sector. So that is very visible, and one of the symbol is the Crew Dragon by SpaceX. As you know, about this time last year, the first private sector vehicle that brought human being to the space, and this is our first operational flight and myself. I'm from international partner. So this going and coming back to the Earth, between the Earth and the space, Crew Dragon is being utilized. And also there are other companies as well that are also providing different vehicles to the space. So at this time, at least, this is the first private-led operational flight. So including training, preparation, and rescue operation as well, everything were completed by private sector. So that kind of mechanism is now already available. So that kind of private sector that can provide those services are now available, which is a major change from the past, I think. Thank you very much. So as you said, currently the space development is now changing from state-led to private sector, I think.
それによって、我々の社会や経済がどういうふうに変化していくというふうにお考えでしょうか。
はい、ありがとうございます。そうですね、もちろん国家が主導して進める宇宙探査の分野というのはこれからも残ると思います。一方で、地球の周りで展開されるような宇宙ビジネスにおいてはやはり民間企業の、イノベーション、クリエイティブなマインドを生かした活動っていうのが徐々に中心になっていくんではないかなと思います。でそういった意味でやはり何といってもすでにそういう会社が現れているってことは、この、宇宙に行くこと、宇宙で行うビジネスが、もうすでに収益化しているということですよね。私、呉さん の, 記事ウェブで拝見しましたけども、まさにイケてるマネタイズが宇宙で実現しつつあるっていうことだと思います。実際にスペース X は収益を上げているわけですし、これからその後続いてアメリカで非常に多く発生している宇宙ベンチャー、どんどんその収益化を進めて、宇宙で儲かるからこそ、宇宙で経済活動が成り立つからこそ、宇宙に進出するという時代にもうなっているんだと思います。
今の話とも関係するんですが、先日のインタビューで野口さんが、地球だけで完結する産業がなくなっていくんじゃないかというふうなお話をされていました。今後これから、宇宙ビジネスが、より大きな産業になっていく上で、その鍵となるようなテクノロジーの、課題であったりとか、ブレイクスルーするこうきっかけになるようなトリガーについてどんなものがあるかというところでお考えをお聞かせ願えますでしょうか。
はい、ありがとうございます。私はね、多分郷さんとかから比べると旧世代に属するので、昭和の高度成長時代のことを知っていますけど、まさに当時のドメスティックな市場から
I know those times of the 昭和 era so compared to the domestic market going into the global standard and we were required to have various changesAnd I believe that those kind of changes were there have been difficulties as Japan went into internationalized and those kind of changes.
当然ながらそこではさまざまなイノベーション、それから変革が求められると思いますけれども、
And of course there would be various innovation, various changes would be needed. But currently, U.S. is taking lead, and U.S. is having a utilization, and the private sector commercialization is advancing. So that kind of wave would come.Eventually. Thank you very much for that response. On the other hand, there are sustainability and SDGs. Those are the one of the trend to try to solve the global scale issues in space and we to face the economy and the society is to face.And are there any potential in the space business? So could you cite any example that may have potential in that area of the space utilization?
に、まあね、象徴されるような、まさにこのサステイナ
ブル。Thank you for that question. SDGs is one of the symbols, and in order to make a sustainable society, how can we utilize space?And maybe the policy perspective in space development will be can be utilized. That is the change of the Earth seen from the space, or the technology utilizing space for the environmental control. Because here in ISS, we are using solar energy for the control of this environment. And also water, we are 100% recycling already.Here in the International Space Station. And of course, if human beings are to go to Moon and Mars and further into deep space, we have to be able to have the environmental utilization in closed environment. And that type of technology can be tested and verification. That's what ISS serves, and also Moon Station would also serve.So in that sense, I think space development is very important in terms of SDGs as well. Well, thank you very much for that response. So you are doing, I believe, various types of experiments for those purposes as well. So next question, I'm going to change the perspective. And as I said earlier,This moon or Mars or a new economic sphere,Maybe needed in order for the companies to be going into those areas. And what kind of new perspective would be needed by a business person or those people who go into space?
はい、ありがとうございます。実はまさに我々がその辺をむしろね。
Well, thank you for that question. And actually, those are the areas actually we would like to hear from top management of private sector. So, because we would like to hear very free fresh mindset and creativity. So, in that sense, we are waiting for those kind of proposal. Because in terms of space development, we have very good content and we have very good, excellent players. However, in order to make those elements to be profitable, we do not have those paths, and that's the weakness of ours, I'm afraid. So maybe not only Japan, but the world business person can utilize our content and make them profitable and commercialize. So to create that kind of path under the great vision and working together, then that will create a great result. Oh, thank you very much.And I would like to ask that well, you said that you need a business person in space field. And those people that are working together with you, and are there any common mind or passion do you find that they're working in a space at the moment?
現在日本に限らずね、世界でこの宇宙開発の最前線で働いている。
So it's not limited to Japan, but those that are working at the front of the space exploration, those young people, they know that their activity would open the frontier for the future. They have the passion, I believe. But what's not enough at the moment is to
国から与えられた政策を実行するという意味では予算をいただいてね、それを確実に実行するというのは過去何十年もやってるわけですけども、
The policy that are provided and make it sure to do that, and we have done that for the last tens of years. But in order to make it advanced and in this society, and what kind of needs and what are the seeds and how we can grow them and then make them as a business, and then that's what is not sufficient. And the business person, together with business.Person, we would like to work more.
ありがとうございます。なるほど。
Thank you very much.
おそらくまだ、so, 地球にいる我々は
so now,
宇宙を身近に感じられないので、
are not feeling so close to the space, and maybe that's the reason why I do not feel that we can participate to the space exploration. But very shortly, we are going to have the real private tourism into the space. So eventually we are going to have more and more people who have experience to go to the space in the private sector as well. And when that
happens, how will the world change? In this case,
how do you think about it? Yes, thank you. Well, thank you for the question. Well, thank you for the question.JAXA という組織にいますけども、普通の人間ですから、
I am in JAXA、
体験したね、
and I'm a person, ordinary man, and I am one of the person who had experienced the space, and I would like to communicate what I have experienced, my experience to you. That was my biggest, one of the motivation for this third mission. So what I felt in the space, what are the business scene, seen from the space, and communicate to people of those aspects, and I hope that we would have more people who would go into the space. And it is often said in the past that it's around the corner that people go to the commercial tourism, but only this year
and that is going to be a little bit modified and that is utilized to be a private sector.
Site. And so it's really reality. And when that happens, and then what kind of business scene impact are we going to have, and how are we going to deal with and do this space and activity, and how we can expand this to the world?
ありがとうございます。いや、おっしゃる通りだなというふうに思います。ではですね、逆に。どうやって より宇宙を多くの人間にですね、身近に感じさせていくかっていうところで、例えば、今後野口さんが期待されてらっしゃるその宇宙の広め方であったりとか、宇宙を広めるポテンシャルを持った人材、あるいはビジネスの領域、何かそういったところで期待されている分野などはあるでしょうか。
はい、ありがとうございます。従来はですね、やはり我々のその活動を知っていただくために、メディアの皆さんとね、協力していろんなこう活動を展開してきてますけれども、まさにこれからは
両さんたちのようなウェブサービスの分野で、At this time, such as a web service area, such as GoSan, how we can
やはりね、IT の分野、これからどんどん広がっていくと思いますけれども、昨今言われている、いわゆるデジタルデバイド、情報格差の中で、今、私がむしろ感じているのは、この情報化していく中でですね、発信力がある人は、この IT を使ってどんどん発信していく。
Providing information, those who can send out information, they do that farther and farther, utilizing IT. Communication capability can be very much divided. So digital divide or communication divide may be wider. So there's a danger in that. So in that sense, in the process of digitalization, those who have capability to communicate would go farther and farther to be advanced. And by doing that, I think we have to bring those
ありがとうございます。それではこれで最後の質問になりますが、これから宇宙に進出していく、そんな期待を持っている人材、あるいはビジネスパーソンに対して、野口さんからぜひエールを一言送っていただけますでしょうか。
はい、ありがとうございます。これから宇宙を目指す、若い皆さん、若くなくてもいいですけどね、気持ちが若いだけでも十分ですけれども、宇宙は皆さんの調整を待っています。私自身も宇宙を目指してこういう形で実際に宇宙に来て素晴らしい体験をさせてもらいました。でこれから民間企業皆さん、いろんなイノベーションがこの宇宙という場で結実して、皆さんの未来への夢が叶う場になるといいなと思ってます。皆さんの挑戦をお待ちしてます。
Your dream could be realized. I'm waiting for your challenge. Well, thank you very much. That's all for my interview. I hope that you will be well for the remaining of the day. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for this interview. I really enjoyed it. Thank you so much. Bye bye.
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event. Thank you.
Thank you to all participants from JAXA. Station, we are now resuming operational audio communications.